Look at what happened in Ukraine. Look what happened in France a couple of years ago when Macron decided to quit the Socialist Party and created his own party 11 months before the presidential election. And now he's president of France. I'm not a socialist, but what I'm telling you is there's a populist movement in different countries. Look what happened in Australia. They elected a leader that is against the Paris Accord. So I think that populist movement, it is here in Canada. But we're a little bit different. When they call us a populist party, I'm okay with that. But I prefer to be called a smart populist party, because with our solid policies, our serious policies, we are appealing to the intelligence of people, not to their emotion. So I think, you know, there's a silent majority in Canada that are ready for that.
What do you say to those that are saying, oh, well, out of spite, he's now working for the Liberals and dividing that conservative vote? What do you say to those people?
I think I explained that pretty well. Here in Alberta, Justin Trudeau won't have one of his candidates elected. You're so mad at him that he won't be successful. So you won't split the vote in Alberta. You have two choices, the fake conservative or the real one, and we are the real one. And I'm saying to Albertans, I'm taking care of Justin Trudeau in Quebec. Our party will be very successful also in Quebec, and we'll take some seats from Justin Trudeau in Quebec. So don't be afraid of that. Vote for your values. Vote for the real conservative party. There's only one, and not for Scheer. Scheer, the goal, and he said, now the Conservative Party of Canada under Scheer, it is a centrist party. He said that personally, and he believed in that, and he wants that. And now his goal is to split the Liberal votes. So don't play that game. Come with us and vote for your values, and we'll be successful. And Justin Trudeau won't be Prime Minister the 22nd of October. I will always do public event, and I will always be available. And I won't have time to do background check on everybody that wants to have a photo with me. That's it.
Just to follow up on that, can you name any hate groups in Canada?
What do you mean, name?
Well, like, that's what everybody's accusing you of. Like, oh, he posed for a photo with a hate group. Like,
yeah.
Can you name any hate groups that you know of?
I don't know. I'm too concentrated to speak about what I believe and to explain our position. I don't know. I'm not playing that game. You know, and that's not serious what our opponents are saying about that. They don't want to discuss about the real issues. Everybody knows me, knows my philosophy, my free market. I believe in people. I don't believe in big fat government. I believe in real free market values, real Western civilization values. And so I'm too busy to speak about what you believe, and it's going very well. And I don't have to explain our position on these eight groups. We're not like that. That's it, you know, and it's evident. And people who want to associate us with these people, they're it's ridiculous. And I don't have anything to say. It's ridiculous. I don't have to argue that I'm not a racist.
No, it's not what I'm asking you to do. I was asking you if you know of any hate groups in Canada. Like, are there any, or is there no hate groups?
Maybe, yeah. I don't know. You know, I'm not there. Canadians are not racist. That's my thought. That is a-